Hello students, welcome to MathsWell YouTube channel, a virtual platform for mathematics. Today we are going to discuss one of the important topic from the grade 8 and which is also helpful for the higher studies also, that is of algebraic expressions and the identities. In that topic we are going to discuss about the factorization, in which we are going to discuss the division of the monomials, division of the polynomials and so on. Okay, so we'll discuss this factorization, the division of a monomial, division of binomial, division of polynomial by a monomial and polynomial also. Okay, so let's see the first point, the division of algebra, in short we can say it is a division of algebraic expressions. Okay, the name of the subtopic is division of algebraic expressions. In the last video we have seen how to take the multiplication of the algebraic expressions. Okay, so today we will discuss about the division of algebraic expressions. So algebraic expressions means it may be monomial, it may be polynomial, it may be any type of algebraic expressions. Okay, so first we'll see about the division of a monomial by another monomial. You can say division of monomial by a monomial, obviously it is another monomial. So what are the monomial? As we know, the monomials may be in the form of, suppose consider the example, say 6x cube is divided by 2x, suppose. Okay, so while taking the division of such two monomials, this one is a monomial, the dividend is a monomial, divisor is also a monomial. Expression which is to be divided is called dividend. And which is to be divided means it is divided to a dividend. So that part is called the dividend, divisor here. So here I can say 2x is a divisor and 6x cube is a dividend. Okay. So student, while taking the division of such monomials, we have two methods of finding such divisions of the monomials. What are they? We will see one by one. Okay. Let's see the first method. In the first method, what we do, we just factorize the monomials. What are the factors of monomial here? We have two monomials. The first one is a 6x cube. So we first factorize this. So writing a factorization of the given monomial means we need to factorize the terms in the monomial. Okay, here we have a coefficient part is 6 and the variable part is x cube. So what are the factors of 6? Factors of 6 are nothing but 2 and 3. And the factors of x cube, since it is a x cube, means x should be multiplied 3 times. So I can write it as x into x into x. So these are the factors of the dividend, that is 6x cube. Also we have the factors of 2x. What are the factors of 2x? Factors of 2x, if we see the term 2 and x, so these are the two factors here. Again we need to factorize them. So since 2 is already a prime number, factorization means what? We need to write the all prime factors for the given number as well as the variables. Okay, variable part. So 2 and x, here 2 is already a prime number, so it cannot be factorizable again, so we can keep it as it is. And here x is having its higher power 1 only, so since it is in linear form, so again it cannot be reduced in the lower power of x, so it is already a lower one, so I can write it as x only. So here we have the two factors 2 and x. So now to take the division of such polynomials, what we do? We take write the division of these two. So 6x cube is divided by 2x. Then write down their prime factors. It is 2 into 3 into x into x into x. And then it is divided by the factors of the denominator monomial, that is 2x, which is equal to 2 into x. Okay, so what we have here in this, what we left, if we take here, we can take the common factors. What are the common factors here? If you see, here I can write the numerator column or numerator factors which are common with denominator together. That is 2 into x is taken together and remaining factors written in another bracket like 2, 3 into x, because x is taken 3 times, 1x is taken with this 2 and the remaining 2 are taken with this 3 and is divided by, again the denominator is having the factors as 2 into x. Okay, so if you see in the numerator, what we can say, can you cancel these common factors we are having here, 2 into x and 2 into x, so these are the common factors, so I can cancel them. And what we left here, you can have here, it is 3 into x into x, 3 into x into x, that can be written as a 3x square, which is again a monomial. So here student, we can say the division of two monomials will also be a monomial only, right? So this is the method of finding the division of two monomials, right students? So we can do the division of monomial with monomial in this way. So now we'll see the division of polynomial with a monomial. Okay, we are going to divide a polynomial, means what? We are having expression with more than two terms. Okay, so let's consider the second division, that is called division of a polynomial by a monomial. Right, so in this case student, consider any example. Suppose the example is given is like this. Suppose the you are asked to find or take the division or divide a polynomial. Suppose the polynomial given is, say it is 4y cube plus 5y square plus 6y. This is the polynomial, and we need to divide this polynomial or this dividend by a monomial. And what is that monomial? The monomial is 2y, suppose, right students? So this is the division here. The polynomial which is to be divided is having the terms more than 2 or more than 2, so it is called a polynomial, and by which it is to be divided, that is 2y, which is a monomial. So here we are going to discuss how to take the division of polynomial by a monomial. So as we have done in the last example, that is last type of the division we have seen, that division of monomial with monomial, the same case here we can use, the same method, that method can also be used here. How it can be used, let us see. So student, what we do again, as we have done in the last case, we have factorized the monomials. So here also we do the same, since polynomial is having the sum or difference of monomials, right? So we can factorize all these monomials in the given polynomial. So let us write the factors. We write the polynomial given as it is and then write their factors. So now let's write the factors of 4y cube. What are the factors of 4y cube? The factors of 4y cube can be written as 2 into 2, then the factors of y cube can be written as y into y into y, and then the factors, okay, this is 4y cube, this is over. Now plus, what are the factors of 5y square? Since 5 is a prime number, it cannot be factorized again, so it will be written as it is. And then y square, since its power is 2, I need to write this y 2 times in multiplication. And then we have the constant term 6, so which is not a prime factor, but can be factorized as 2 into 3. Understood? Yes. And then we need to factorize 2y. So since 2y is a monomial and 2y and y both are the 2 is a prime number already, and y is having its power 1, so no need to factorize it. So in such case, what we do? So we write the factors as 2 into y. The factor of 2y is 2 into y, and then note down the division. So what will be the division? Let us see. 4y cube plus 5y square plus 6 is divided by 2y. So what we do here, we convert the division of the polynomial by monomial in terms of division of monomial by dividing each monomial in the given polynomial by the monomial 2y separately. So I can divide this 2y to each of these three terms. So I can write it like this: 4y cube divided by 2y, then 5y square divided by 2y, and then plus 6 upon 2y. 6 is divided by 2y, right? So here what we have, so it is equal to, so as we have the factors of 4y cube, we can write the factors of 4y cube as, I will rewrite these factors since I have denoted as 2y, and if I have the factors 2y and y with this, I will take those 2y and y together in one bracket. So 2 into y taken together is multiplied by the remaining factors. They are 2 into y, understood? And is divided by the factors of denominator. Monomial is 2 into y, so it will be kept as it is. Plus, write on the factors of 5y square as we have done there in the previous steps. So we can write it as 5 into y, and then it is divided by 2y because we don't have the factors 2y in numerator, so it can be written as it is. Plus, the factors of 6 are 2 and 3, so we'll write it as it is, 2 into 3, and the factors of denominator are 2 into y. So now if we have the common factors in numerator and denominator, we can cancel them. So here in the first division of monomials, 2 and y are the common factors, will get cancelled. In the second term we have 1y is common, so that will also be get cancelled. And in the third term, coefficient part 2 can get cancelled, which is common in numerator and denominator both. And then we can write the remaining terms. What we left after taking this division of monomials, we have the in the first term we are living with this 2 into y, right? Then in the second term we left with 5 into y, and in denominator we left with only 2. Plus in the third term we left with 3 upon y only. Or rewriting this, we can say it is equal to 2y square plus 5y2y plus 3 upon y, or 3 into 1 by y. Both are one and the same. So this will be the required division, or we can say the quotient of the division of two polynomial by a monomial. Understood, students? So this is the method of finding the division of a monomial with a polynomial by a monomial. So that is the answer here. Clear? Yes. I think the third term is 6y. Instead of 6, the third in the monomial, the polynomial is 6y. If it is 6y, what happened? You can write the factor y here in each term. So this is 6 into y. So I can have here 6 into y. So from this, student, this y will also get cancelled. So y will not be there. So that our answer will be equal to 3 only in the third term, which is only 3. Y will not be there in denominator. So in this way, student, we have the division of polynomial by a monomial. I hope everyone understood this. So now let's move ahead with the next part of next method or next type of the division of algebraic expressions, that is the division of polynomial by a polynomial. This is the third type of division of algebraic expressions. So let us see. It is division of a polynomial by a polynomial. Right, so this is the third type of division of algebraic expressions. Okay, so let us see the example here. To take the division of polynomial, what we need to do here? We need to take the factors again. So factorize all the monomials there in the numerator, and then if possible we can take the factors common with the factors in the denominator, and cancelling it will give us the required division of two polynomials. So here student, we can have two methods of finding the division of this polynomial with polynomial. What it is, let us see. We will consider the first method, method number one, in which we have the division of polynomial by a polynomial. Suppose the example given is like this: 7x cube plus 14x. This is a polynomial. It is divided by polynomial x plus 2. So what we do in this case? Let us consider the first method. So again, as usual, we just factorize the numerator and denominator first. Since the denominator is already a polynomial in linear form x plus 2, we keep it as is and try to divide or try to factorize the numerator in terms of x plus 2 if possible. Okay, let us see. So what will happen? So let's factorize the numerator. This 7x cube plus 14x is equal to. So let us factorize each term here and check whether we can have x plus 2 as a common factor from this. So 7 is a prime number, so it can be written as it is, not factorizable. Then x cube can be factorized as x into x into x as usual. It is multiplication of x 3 times. Plus factors of 14. It is a composite number, so we can have its factors as 2 into 7 or 7 into 2. Okay, 7 into 2. And is multiplied by x. Since x is in linear form, the power of x is 1, so no need to factorize again. So it will be written as it is. So student, what we have, if you see the factors of both the terms here in the polynomial, I have common 7 in both, and x is also there in both the factors. So I can take 7x common from this. If I take 7x as common, what will left? What will left here? Wait, I think something is mistake here. Instead of cube, here it is square. Yes, it is not a cube, but it is square. So if it is square, what will happen? We have the factors of 7x square as only 7 into x, right? So what are the factors here? The factors, common factor we have is 7x. So taken 7x common, so what we left in the bracket? We left with this 1x with this from the first term. The addition remains same, and then we left with this 2 from the second term, that is x plus 2. So student, we have the factors of the numerator, that is the dividend, 7x square plus 14x is equal to 7x into x plus 2. So these are the two factors of the given polynomial in numerator, that is dividend. And now the divisor is x plus 2 already, so it cannot be factorized as it is already a linear polynomial only, linear binomial. It has the factors of x. X is taken only once. Since it is linear form, it cannot be factorized again. And 2 is also prime number, so it cannot be factorized. So it can be written as it is. So now, if I take the division of these two, what we have? 7x square plus 14x is divided by x plus 2. So what we have here? Write down the factors here from numerator. It is 7x into x plus 2, and then in denominator we have x plus 2. So if you observe the numerator and denominator, so can you see a common factor among these two? Yes, we have x plus 2 as a common factor, which will get cancelled, and you left with only 7x here. So that will be the required answer, the division of a polynomial by a polynomial. Right, students? So hope everyone got this. Now we'll see the second method of finding the division, that is known as a long division method. That is also one of the method of dividing polynomial by a polynomial, long division method. So what is that long division method? Let us discuss here. So here we consider the same example. So by both of these two methods, the answer must be same. So let us see. So we divide 7x square plus 14x by a polynomial x plus 2. You can write it like this. So while taking the division of polynomial by a polynomial, students, first we see the given dividend. Here the term which is to be divided is called dividend, and the polynomial by which the dividend is divided is called a divisor, as we were discussing previously also. So here x plus 2 is called divisor, and 7x square plus 14x is called a dividend. So while taking the division of such polynomial by polynomial, first try to write this dividend in the powers of x in descending order. Means first we need to write the higher power term, and then go on writing the terms with the powers less by 1. Here if it is 2, then after that we need to write the term of x with power 1, then 0. If it is higher power of x is 4, then we need to write 4, 3, 2, 1 like that. Okay, we need to write the terms of x with the powers in descending order. Okay, that is on in decreasing order. Okay, descending means to write it in decreasing order, right? And the same thing in divisor also, right? So here the higher power of x is 2. So here is 2, and second term must have the power of x as 1. So here no power of x given means it is supposed to be the power 1 only. Clear? And in divisor also it is x plus 2. The power of x here not given means it is 1. And then the constant term. That's all. So already both of these two, divisor as well as dividend, both are in ascending orders, in the ascending order of the powers. So we keep them as they are, no need to change. If they are not in that order, we need to write them in that order. So why we should write it in that way? Because we are taking the divisions, and the division can be taken by dividing the higher degree term or higher power term of the dividend by higher power term of the divisor. So here in the dividend we have 7x square is the higher degree term, right? The power of x is higher here in this dividend. So this is the higher degree term of this dividend, and the higher power term in the divisor is x. So we need to take the division of 7x square with x. So what we left here, student? What we left? It is 7x square divided by x. So using the laws of exponent, since here 7 is remain as it is, and x square by x, by using the laws of exponent, we can say it is 2 minus 1. The power of x will be 2 minus 1, means it is 7x only. Or if we know, or if we cancel this, if it is possible for you, you can cancel a power by 1 or minimize the power of this x in numerator by 1, since here the power is 1 only in denominator. So that is 2 minus 1. So here it is done by using the law of exponent given by a raised to m by a raised to n, or x raised to m by x raised to n, which is equal to x raised to m minus n. So this law is used to simplify the x term, right? So in this way, student, we have, so whatever here we left will be the first term. We call it as the first term in the quotient of division. Whatever the division we are taking, the term we are having in the quotient will be this one. This is the first term in the quotient. So here that should be written here, that is 7x. And what is the next step? We need to multiply this term we obtained here in the quotient to both of these two terms in the divisor, and those should be returned, that product should be returned just below to these two terms in dividend, right? So what is the product of 7x with x1s? Since 7, no coefficient for x in divisor, so it will be 7 remain as it is, and x into x will be x square, right? Plus 7x is multiplied to 2. So how much is the product of 7x and 2? So 7 2s are 14, so x will remain as it is. And the very important step is, here we need to take the difference of these two. So while taking the difference, we need to change the sign of each term. Whatever the product here we are writing, while taking the difference, we need to change the sign of these two terms. And then if you see here, the terms are like terms and they are having equal and opposite terms. 7x square and then minus 7x square, 14x and minus 14x. So what we are having in the remainder? So 7x square minus 7x square gets cancelled. 14x and minus 14x will also get cancelled. So nothing is left means what? The remainder is 0. Here we can write whatever we left here is called the remainder. Right? So here remainder is 0 means we need to stop the division. Right? So in this way, what we have the quotient? So the quotient is 7x means what we say? We say that the division of these two polynomial, or we can write that 7x square plus 14x divided by x plus 2 is equal to 7x only. Right? So the answer we are getting in the both methods. In the previous first method, we are getting the answer as 7x, and in this long division method also, we are having the answer as 7x only. So the answer will not change even you use any one of these two methods. So students, I think you understood this methods of finding the division of polynomial by a polynomial, right? So let's try one more example of this long division method. You might have some doubt in this, so I will just solve one more example of this division method and then we'll stop. Okay, so let's see one more example of taking the division of polynomial by a polynomial by using this long division method. Okay, let's see. So consider this example. Yes, 10x minus 25 divided by pi, or we can consider this 10x minus 25 divided by 2x minus 5. Consider this example, or we can have some more examples here. Yes, I will take this y square plus 7y minus 10 plus 10. So let's divide this. Divide y square plus 7y plus 10 is divided by, it is divided by y plus 5. So let us divide this by using long division method. It is the second example for this long division method. So again, let's divide. So y plus 5 is divided to y square plus 7y plus 10. Okay, so here we have a dividend and this one is a divisor. So already if you see, if you observe the terms, already the polynomial is in the form of descending order of the powers of y. Okay, here the variable is y. So, and both divisor as well as the dividend, both are in the powers in descending order. So no need to change the terms. So we'll keep it as it is. So while performing the long division method, what we do, the first step is we need to divide the higher degree terms of both divisor as well as dividend. So we need to divide the higher power term of dividend by the higher power term of divisor. Means we need to divide y square to by y. So since y square by y square can be factorized as y into y, and y is single term, so it will be kept as it is. So 1y will get cancelled and you will left with only y. So this is your first term in the quotient. You say it is the first term in the quotient. Okay. So that first term in the quotient should be written here. And whatever we left, we got the first term in the quotient, that should be written, that should be multiplied to these two terms in the divisor. So y into y will become y square, and y into 5 will become 5y, the product will be 5y. So in this way we have the product of the first term of quotient with the divisor is y square plus 5y. So we need to take the subtraction of these two, difference of these two, so that I need to change the sign for these two terms. So if you see here, while taking the difference, we need to check the we need to write the like terms together. So the like term y square with y square, the term of y with y just below to one another, right? So if you have the like terms with equal coefficient, means they are the similar terms with opposite sign, so that will get cancelled. So here I have y square with minus y square, means they are equal and opposite terms, so that will get cancelled. And I left with 7y and minus 5y. So while taking the difference of the monomials, the variable remain as it is. I need to take the difference of coefficient part. So that is 7 minus 5. So 7 minus 5 will be equal to 2. And now whatever the left here in the dividend, so that will be taken with this remainder. So I have 2y plus 10, right? So now to get the second term in the quotient, what we need to do, we need to divide again the higher degree term in the this remainder, right? Whatever we have, again we consider this as a dividend again, means this will be dividend and this will be divisor. Divisor remains same and this dividend will go on changing. And we need to continue the very important step, students, just listen. 2y plus 10, here we need to continue the division till the degree of this remainder is greater than or equal to the degree of the divisor. Degree means what? The higher power of the variable in these two. The higher power of variable here for this is higher power of y is 1, and here also the higher power of y is 1. So degree of both of them is equal, so we can continue, we can have one more step. Okay, we can divide this higher degree term again, this we consider this as a dividend and divide it by divisor. The process again remains same. We need to divide higher degree term by the higher degree term of these two, dividend and divisor, as we have done in the first step. So the higher degree term is 2y in the dividend and y is in divisor, so we need to divide it. So again, it's very simple. 2y upon y means we need to factorize this 2 and y as 2 into y, and y remain as it is. This y will get cancelled, so we left with only 2, right? And that 2 is nothing but the second term. We say it is the second term in the quotient, right? So that should be written over here in the quotient with y. So it is y plus 2. So as we have done in the previous step, whatever the term we are having in the quotient, so that should be multiplied to the each term of the divisor. The same thing should be done here. The we are having 2, that 2 will be multiplied to y plus 5, both of these two terms in the divisor. So 2 into y, obviously it is 2y, and 2 into 5 is equal to 10. So taken the difference again, we need to change the sign of these two. So this will again, if you check whether we are having like terms, if they are having like terms and equal coefficients, those terms will get cancelled if they have equal and opposite sign. So obviously we have 2y minus 2y, they are equal and opposite term, will get cancelled. And plus 10 and minus 10, again they are equal and opposite term. So both terms are getting cancelled, means what we left in the denominator, remainder, we left with only 0. So this is known as a remainder. So since remainder is 0, we stop here only. And whatever the term we are getting in the quotient, that will be the required answer here. So hence I can say here The answer for this example, that is y square plus 7y plus 10 divided by y plus 2 is equal to, sorry, it is y plus 5 is equal to, the answer we are getting is y plus 2. So that is your answer. So student, hope everyone understood how to get the division of polynomial by a polynomial by using long division method. So in this video we have discussed the very important part of the topic algebraic expressions, and that we have seen the factorization and the division of the polynomials. First we have seen division of monomial by monomial, then we have seen the division of polynomial by a monomial, and then thirdly we have seen the division of polynomial by a polynomial by using three methods, right? So this part we have seen, right? So student, here in that division of polynomial by a polynomial we have seen two methods. The first method we have seen, just by factorizing each term in the numerator and dividing by the divisor and getting the common term, cancelling the common term, you will get the answer for them. That is the division of the two polynomials. In the second method we have seen long division method, in which again we need to divide using the long division method. Means in that also we need to use the same concept of dividing monomial by a monomial while taking the division of each term here. We need to divide each term of this dividend by the quotient terms there. Okay, so in this way we have the answer. So hope students everyone understood these methods of having the division of polynomial, that is polynomial by a monomial, polynomial by polynomial, or monomial by monomial, right? So with this note, we'll see in the next method, next video, we'll see some more interesting topic from the various standards. So today we'll stop here only. Thank you.